Yo, what's up guys? This is Mike Williams, another episode of Me in the Studio. I want to show you guys something cool. Today I started on a track, on a melody, and maybe it's cool to have a look on how I actually start a track, how I start a project. The cameraman was already filming me, so let's have a look at that. Is are vetter dit. So I'm now working on a new melody. I have something in my head, but I'm not sure how it's gonna sound exactly. So now I'm just gonna record it and then I can change everything on the computer. Think something like that. So now I'm gonna show you how I built this to a track and I add some more instruments. So let's have a look. So now we only have the piano. It sounds like an old piano. I put some chorus on it. It's a really cool Nexus piano, pop piano, and some equalizer which is empty, so it doesn't do anything. So this is how it sounds now. So it's pretty basic. It's not necessarily the melody that's gonna be the final melody or something, because I always change a bit, but it's good enough to add some more instruments now. So we need maybe another layer of piano, which is one octave lower. Velocity to the notes. And my idea is to start the track with like really this old piano, like sustain. I really want to make it feel really natural, so the velocity of the notes is really important, and that takes a while. Okay. So now I'm just gonna add some chords for the atmosphere. I have a lot of presets here that I save. Starting on here. So I just, for this synthesizer, it's really easy to have just a fixed velocity, because otherwise every note is going to sound really weird and different. So I just put one velocity in there. Get rid of the top melody. And add the chords. So this is really the boring part, but yeah, you have to just add some more instruments. Also get rid of the sustain, because that's the pedal that I use for the piano, but you don't want to have it during the, if the synthesizer is going to play it. Maybe it's cool to go a bit more higher in the chords here, because the melody also goes higher. So I want to have some extra layers on the chords as well. Yeah. So now I have the chords in there, I'm just gonna make the sound a bit better, because it's really a bit cheap now. So this is the cool chord, which gives it a bit of atmosphere and how do you say it, emotion to the whole track. So that's the beginning. We need a bass line, of course, because we need some low frequencies. Just gonna get rid of everything here. Almost everything. And then we need a cool bass line. I have this one. It's just silent, really. Yeah, really standard. So in the beginning of all the tracks that I make, right at the beginning, I just put a compressor on it, the glue, just to keep it all, to keep the levels a bit down, but nothing else actually. It's just a compression. Maybe it's cool for the synthesizer, the chords to build up a bit with a cutoff. So this is how I made the track so far. I'm not sure what kind of track it's gonna be, if it's gonna be a slow track or a fast track or a radio or club or festival track. I have no idea, I just have the melody and two other instruments. So I let you guys decide what this track is gonna be. If you have any ideas, let me know in the comments below. Also make sure you subscribe, but before we're gonna end this video, we also have the 2 minutes of Q&A. So let's answer some questions. So Music by Aiden is asking me, 1 hour track challenge, ? I'm not sure if I'm gonna do a 1 hour challenge in the studio, because I think it's more about quality instead of how fast you build a track. So I'd rather spend 5 hours on something that sounds better than 1 hour on something that sounds shit. So I'm probably not gonna do it. Grace HTWE is asking me, let me know your address. No. Akash Banner J is asking me, how do you realize that the track is finished or it's time to release? Any tips about it? It's actually quite difficult to know when the track is finished, because also, I always want to work on it even more and more and more. But sometimes there has to be someone else who says to you, or your A&R, or I don't know, someone else, your mom or your dad, to say, yo, this is the track, finish it, sounds good, don't work on it anymore. Mit-Ah is asking me, how you did this big dirty kick in Day or Night? Actually, that's in the previous episode, so you can check that out. It's in the other video. Jazz Pickle, I like the name, is asking me, can you mix a track without headphones? Yeah, you can definitely mix a track without headphones. I think you can mix it in the studio. So, last question from Firdaus X Rahman. How do you usually work with producers that use different programs? You can export certain layers and then they can open it, like in a WAV for MP3 or something else. So you can open it in different programs. Yeah, of course it's easier to work in the same, in Logic, for example, or in FL Studio. So there is a way, but it takes a lot of time. So thank you guys so much for watching this episode. Make sure you subscribe and see you guys next time. Ciao.